ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this week's episode of Robbie T Interviews the Office series. Today, we have none other than Mr. Bobby Ray Shafer, who played Mr. Bob Vance of Vance Refrigeration on the show. Bobby, welcome to the show. Thanks so much for being here.
Thank you, Robbie. It's a pleasure.
I appreciate you taking your time out of your day to join me on the show. So let's start before your office days. When did you first know you wanted to be an actor, and who ultimately helped you on that goal?
Well, I first decided in 1981, and it was an actress named Susan Day, a famous actress from the Partridge Family and later L.A. Law. And she and I were an item, and I went to watch her work, and she suggested that I take some classes, and I did, and I fell in love with acting and became an actor.
Wow, that's an amazing story. So we all know you as, of course, Bob Vance from The Office. Can you take us through the audition process of you getting the role of Bob Vance, and ultimately the moment that you found out you had the role?
Well, it's a funny story, because the first audition was on Halloween, and I didn't even know it was Halloween. I'm not into Halloween. And so there was a lot of traffic going into Hollywood, and the audition was for Allison Jones, who's, of course, one of the great comedy casting directors in L.A. And so I was excited to have the meeting, but I didn't know why there was all this traffic. And so it was it took me longer than it normally did, and there was no parking, and then I saw the people in the costumes, and I realized, oh, it's Halloween in Hollywood. They have a big party there every year, right? So that explained all the difficulty in getting to the audition. So I'm running late. I'm the last guy of the day. I'm pouring sweat because I had to sprint into the office. And I do the audition a couple of times, and, it went well. And then I left. And as I left, there were these girls out front dressed as angels, and they started screwing around with me with their wands and stuff. And I thought, oh, this is an omen. Well, I didn't hear anything back for a couple of weeks. And then I got a call for a callback at the soundstage where the show was shot out in Van Nuys. And so I went for the callback, and Phyllis was there, and there were a bunch of guys, I knew most of the competition. And I think to this day that really it was Phyllis who, chose me. I'd like to think so. But anyway, I was selected, and the next morning I was on the set, first guy up, and first time out is Bob Vance, Vance Refrigeration.
Wow, that's a great story. Are you still close to Phyllis today?
We still text occasionally. Yeah, oh yeah, we'll always be, simpatico.
Oh yeah. So what were your first thoughts of your character, Bob Vance?
Well, it was a one episode deal. That's all I knew. Oh, wow. And, certainly I hoped that it would be recurring, because, Bob was her boyfriend and it was the office next door. But I had to wait 13 episodes. I did the 10th episode of season 2, and then I did Casino Night, which is the last episode of the year. Yep. So that was the first time that Bob came back. And, from that point on, it was sporadic, but, I got to do most of the parties and, make some impact with a pretty small role, really.
So you mentioned that you were the first one on set for your first day. Can you take us through your first day on set? Like, what was going through your mind? And also, what scene were you filming that day?
Well, the scene that I shot that day did not make broadcast. It was me out with some guys on the loading dock unloading a truck and, improvising. And it was pretty silly, really. I didn't know much about the character. I mean, I was just, trying to be funny. So then the next scenes were, the infamous Christmas party, which is a great episode. And so I knew more about him then. And, it was really a Casino Night when Phyllis and I hit upon the idea just to, be madly in love. and just do that. That was pretty much all I did, was be disturbed by Michael and be in love with Phyllis. So it was pretty easy.
Yes. What was it like working with such a great cast? And I know you were close with Phyllis, but was there anybody else on the cast that you grew close with?
Well, yeah, Creed and Stanley, Leslie David Baker, the cast is amazing. I mean, there were times that it was very musical. You know, good comedy is musical. And there were times, for instance, there's the bidding scene where we bid for a hug from Phyllis.
Yes.
And if you watch that, that's very musical. It's almost like hearing them sing Oklahoma with the wind comes rushing down the way. But anyway, that one take that made broadcast, we just nailed that. I mean, every single person was exactly on the rhythm of it. And I knew it right after that take, you know. So there were moments like that where everybody was just at the top of their game. And then there's other moments where everybody's tired and, you know, struggling. So, I mean, it's not an easy game, that's for sure, because it requires such vast powers of concentration.
And you had the honor of working with Des Moines only Michael Scott. What was it like working with Steve Carell?
Well, Steve is obviously a comic genius and very, very funny. And the thing about working with him is that he was always busy preparing the next scene, right? I mean, yeah. He was carrying every scene he's in, or, you know, every scene is ultimately about Michael Scott. I mean, yeah. That's just the way it rolls. And of course, the show suffered without Michael Scott, you know, when it wasn't about Michael Scott. But I stayed out of his way and appreciated it. I really liked working with him. You know, we had good times when we did. And I think he's, you know, true talent. I mean, look at his range. He can do it all. I mean, yep. He's played extremely dramatic roles. And Michael Scott's I think in television history, a vastly underrated character, a really seminal character, one of the great roles in television history. And yeah. He was never won the Emmy for that. So
yes.
That tells you all you need to know about the Emmy.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he won the Golden Globe, but didn't win the Emmy.
Well, you know, Golden yeah. Globe, I mean.
Yeah.
Not the Emmy.
So through all the scenes that you had on The Office, you had some pretty iconic ones. What was your favorite scene that you had? And can you take us through the day?
Well, I mean, Phyllis's wedding, obviously that episode, I was more involved in that episode than any of the others. And, you know, the great moment, of course, in that episode is when we're in the reception line and Michael walks up and says, if you ever lay a finger on Phyllis, I'll kill you. And I say, if you ever lay a finger on Phyllis, I'll kill you. Well, they screened that episode at Greg Daniels, the executive producer, creator of the show, his house. There was a party. And so there were all these people, the cast was there. And Harold Ramis, the actor, writer, director, Harold Ramis, Ghostbusters, Harold Ramis, he was there. And he walks up to me and Phyllis were standing out on the porch. And he says, Bob Vance, Vance Refrigeration. I said, Mr. Ramis, that's my line. Anyway, so we watched the episode and I'm watching Harold Ramis watch the episode. And we get to that, if you ever lay a finger on Phyllis, I'll kill you. And I kill him. I just kill him with it. And so that was a great memory for me because, you know, I killed Harold Ramis and the whole cast, you know, love that line reading.
One of my favorite scenes of the whole show is actually in that episode where Michael has his speech about the well. He says definition of wedding is the
welding. Fusion. Yeah. Yeah, that speech gets him tossed. He actually got hurt when we filmed that.
Oh,
we go through the curtains there. I grab him and take him through the curtains. And he rolled his ankle. We had these three stairs we had to go down. And his foot got stuck in these curtains and he fell. And, you know, he had hurt the ankle on Evan Almighty. So it was already weak. And he was down for a while. The rest of the episode, he was really struggling to even walk. I mean, it was, he played hurt.
Yeah, that's very interesting.
Yeah.
So also, not only you had your iconic episodes yourself, but you were almost in the most iconic episode, of course, the finale. So take us through that day and what were the emotions? I mean, this cast has been together for 9 years, so ending a show after 9 years can't be easy.
Well, I mean, it's bittersweet for sure. I mean, the safety of it, the camaraderie of it. I mean, that's a long time, to have the same crew. I mean, and the crew didn't really turn over very much. The writers did, of course, midway through. But the cast was very, very close, and they still are, I mean, it was time to move on. I mean, essentially when Steve left, I thought it was time to move on. But, it was great that he was there. Because nobody knew, that I didn't know he was going to be there. And then I heard him. And I said to Phyllis, that sounds like Steve. And she said, oh, he's here. And of course, he got that's what she said, the last one into the series there. Great way to end it.
Yes. Yes. It's one of his most famous lines. I love that line. I actually have that. I actually have that line on one of my blankets.
Okay. Well, we at one of the rap parties one year, somebody in the editing department assembled all of them together in, I think it's even, maybe there's a version of it on YouTube where all the That's What She Said are together.
I think I've seen that.
Yeah, it just killed us. We thought we were the funniest people. I mean, even we find ourselves funnier than even the audience found it.
So looking back at it now and realizing how big The Office is, and it's probably one of the most biggest shows in American television history, how does it feel to be a part of that in such a big way?
Well, it's destiny, fate, luck, fortune, all those good fortune, all those things. As you said, there's never been a show like it. I mean, it got bigger after we left the air, way yes. bigger. The audience demographic completely changed. When we were on the air, it was, 30, 40 year olds with household incomes of $100,000 plus. I mean, we were never a ratings hit when we were on. We were always in the 40s and 50s in the Nielsen's. Grey's Anatomy beat us every Thursday. I mean, we never beat them. And then it was when it went on to Netflix, and then the show, the audience became 11, 12, 13 year olds. I mean, it was a shocking change to me. I went to Scranton to throw out a pitch at a baseball game, and it was kids there. I was signing autographs with kids. I was like, when did the audience change?
Yeah.
Because I always thought it was, sophisticated 30 year olds. And then there's all these kids running up to me saying, I binge watched it. And I'm like, oh, okay.
Yeah. Well, it's such a great show.
I feel fortunate to be part of it.
Yeah, I can imagine.
I still play Bob Vance almost every day on cameo.com. I mean, I do, birthdays and weddings and anniversaries, and I've broken up with people. I mean, Bob Vance still lives every single day. You see, this is the Bob Vance studio behind you right there. There's a picture of Phyllis on the wall. Got my hats, got my signs.
I love the hat.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Well, that big of a character never leaves you, right? Such a big part of, your life. Yeah.
Well, I've been Bob Vance for 16 years. So, yeah.
So many old shows have been rebooted recently. Do you think The Office should be rebooted? And if yes, would you play Bob Vance again?
Well, of course I would play Bob Vance. Who else would play Bob Vance? There is no other Bob Vance.
Of course.
Yeah, sure, I'd be happy to. I don't see it happening, frankly, but that's a lot of balls to juggle to get into the same arena. I mean, and time, it's, how long has it been? We've been off the air since 2013, so 8 years already. So yeah. That's considerable aging.
Yeah, that's a long time. The Roseanne show was just rebooted. And I've heard rumors about it possibly being rebooted, but I think it has to. Ultimately, I believe it's Steve Carell's choice. You know.
Yes and no. I mean, Greg Daniels is the one that would have to make it go. I mean, he and Carell failed, of course, with the Space Force series. Yeah. I mean, that didn't hit. I mean, just goes to show you that, you know, it doesn't work every single time.
Exactly.
You don't hit a home run every time out, okay?
Yep.
You hit plenty of singles and make plenty of outs.
Yep. So since The Office has ended, I know you mentioned you do cameos and you're still Bob Vance, of course, but how has your life been post-Office and what are you working on now?
Well, I'm semi-retired, really, from the active day-to-day. You know, I don't live in Hollywood anymore. And life's good. I mean, it's after 40 years of, you know, nose to the grindstone, chasing the dream, fighting every day. I mean, I miss the competition a little bit. You know, I don't miss sitting on the freeway, but because there was a lot of that. And, you know, for a time I had a 69 Cadillac, and when gas prices, you know, that baby only got like 10 miles to the gallon, but it looked good. You know, it was a 69 Cadillac.
It's a nice car.
Oh, it's a beauty.
So happy retirement. What advice would you give to young people trying to become actors nowadays?
To become an actor?
Yes.
Well, that's, you know, training, first of all. I mean, you have to learn how to be an actor. It's not just something somebody turns on a camera and you're acting. You have to be like a golfer and be able to repeat the swing. That's really, there's a lot of technique involved. I mean, you need to learn how to build a character. I mean, that's really crucial because you're not always yourself.
Yeah.
You know, I played a lot of different roles. I mean, I wasn't an oil worker or a murderer, or, you know, but I had to get into those mindsets. So you have to learn how to create characters. And then, of course, you have to learn how to execute. And film execution and theater execution, those are two different things. And that comes with practice. I mean, so I always say you take the classes, you learn, and then you start auditioning, you know. You make your own movie. I mean, with camera technology now, people can make their own movie. I mean, Sony 7Ds and you're shooting. So, you know, that's the best, fastest way to do anything is find a role that you want to play and write a script and get your friends together and make a movie.
Yep, that's the way to do it. I actually think you sent me a link. Did your own video. It was called Dick Ditzker, right?
I made my own movie.
Yep.
Mockumentary called Dick Ditzker, yes. It's about Hollywood.
Yep, you can do anything you put your mind to. Okay, so now we're going to do something I like to call the lightning round. Just fun questions. First thing that pops into your head, okay?
All right.
Question number one. If you could only live with the rest of your life eating one food, what would you choose?
Steak.
Yeah, good choice. I love steak. What type of steak?
I like New York and ribeye.
Yeah. That's a good. All right. Question.
I like the big, you know, expensive stuff.
Question number two. If you won the lottery, name the first thing you would buy.
That's first thing I would buy if I won the lottery. A hug from Phyllis.
That's a great answer.
Thank you.
All right. What actor had the biggest impact on your career and why?
Robert Duvall.
That's a great actor.
I think because he's such a truth teller and, you know, the way that he did it. I mean, he was an inspiration to watch. The movie Tender Mercies he made, he won the Oscar for that. And that movie always really, I was a beginning actor in those days. I was still in class and I was very motivated by the purity of it, you know, his approach. And I later got to meet him and hang out with him, buy him a beer. I mean, he's a cool dude. And friends of mine got, I never worked with him, but some friends of mine did. And, you know, of course, I read a lot about him and watched all his movies and was always a big fan.
Yeah, he seems like a very humble guy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
All right, next question. Favorite Michael Scott line or scene?
Well, it's a deleted scene.
Oh.
It's at from Phyllis's wedding, and there's a fart. It's a fart scene. It's a famous scene. And he opens the door, and I see Phyllis before the wedding, and we smell the fart. And, you know, when we were shooting it, every time he said the word pungent, he would fall apart. He would crack up. He couldn't make it. So everybody on the set was just laughing. They couldn't stop laughing. And so I was standing outside the door like, do not laugh when he opens that door.
Yes.
But every time he said pungent, it went on for an hour probably. But that moment.
That's, I never saw that deleted scene. I got to look it up and find it.
Yeah, it's out there.
All right, next question. All right, I asked Amir this last week. I'm going to ask you, if you could star in any movie or TV show, what would you choose and why?
If I could star in any movie or TV show, that's a good question. You know, the TV show I would want to star in was Crime Story by Michael Mann. A buddy of mine starred in that. And it was just so one. I mean, it was early Michael Mann, and it was just phenomenal. Dennis Farina was in that. It lasted a couple seasons. That would be the one. Crime Story.
Awesome. All right, and last question: favorite character from The Office, and you can't be biased.
Can't be biased. Come on. That's what Phyllis, of course.
Of course.
No brainer.
Well, that concludes our interview. Thank you, Bobby, so much for taking the time to talk to me. I really, really appreciate it.
Robbie, my pleasure. Keep up the tough, good fight. I know you have your struggles, and I appreciate your effort.
Thank you, my man. Well, everyone, thank you for watching. And until next time, I've been Robbie. Take care, everybody.
Bob Vance Refrigeration. Out.